Welcome to the American Diabetes Association's 73rd Scientific Sessions, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. I'm Anna Baker here at McCormick Place in Chicago with breaking diabetes news and research. All fat is not bad. That is the news that was announced at a press conference held earlier today. In fact, two recent studies showed that exercise creates good fat that can in turn benefit other tissues in the body, improving your metabolism. The studies were funded by the American Diabetes Association and the National Institutes of Health. They looked at mice that ran on an exercise wheel for 11 days, as well as men who underwent 12 weeks of training on an exercise bike. The subjects experienced a browning of the fat found right beneath the skin, which appears to have profoundly changed the way that it behaved in the body. The browner fat actually adapted to become more metabolically active than the white fat that results from an inactive lifestyle. That white fat is the bad fat that can lead to type 2 diabetes and other insulin-resistant conditions. To determine whether the browner fat could affect how the body uses glucose, the researchers transplanted the trained mouse fat into high-fat sedentary mice. They found that those mice showed improved glucose tolerance, improved body composition, decreased fat mass, and increased insulin sensitivity for at least 12 weeks following the treatment. Researchers think that the healthier fat releases factors into the bloodstream that then work on other tissues. Whether transplanting the browner fat would have the same impact in humans is not yet known. So what's the takeaway here? Well, we know that physical activity is good for us, and it turns out it doesn't just affect your muscles, it affects your fat as well. So even if you're not losing weight, know that exercise is still training your fat to improve your overall metabolism and therefore your health. If you need greater motivation to get out there and exercise, this might just be it. This is Anna Baker reporting from the 73rd Scientific Sessions in Chicago. To view this press release online, please visit the For Media section of our website, diabetes.org. And for the latest video coverage of the meeting, stay tuned to diabetes.org/breakingnews.